Welcome to the Prototype Series, a group of videos in which we'll explore creating small projects combining different Unity features. In this episode, we'll give you an overview on how we created this third-person action shooter that has an ability system similar to the ones present in many popular games. We will separate the development process by talking about the adaptation of a free asset pack to start prototyping, our implementation of additional systems like shooting and abilities, and how we use some extra features to enhance the project's visuals. So let's get into it. In any prototyping session, the Asset Store is a great jumping point to download assets that will help you achieve faster results. In this particular case, we thought it would be a great idea to use a 3D game kit not only as a base for gameplay systems, but also as a good example of porting older projects to the Universal Render pipeline. Once we downloaded the 3D game kit, we started rebuilding some of the original shaders from the built-in render pipeline to the Universal Render pipeline using ShaderGraph. Since this feature allows us to create shaders using nodes, we thought it would be a good idea to play around with it and try to develop a shader with a more stylized look. For this effect, we followed the same steps shown in this video we've made in collaboration with the artist MinionsArt, and we'll add a link for it in the description of this video. Toon shading is a great way to make your graphics more stylized. Notice how it allows our objects to have sharper shadows and more vibrant colors. Another new Unity feature we wanted to incorporate was the new input system, which allows you to easily assign new key bindings to any given action. We did this by including the input system package to our project, adding the player input component to our player, and creating an input action asset to determine our key bindings. The 3D game kit also included some gameplay systems, like the character movement, which uses the character controller component, a melee combat system, and a Cinemachine freelook camera rig to build a classic perspective system of a third-person shooter. To expand on these systems, we figured it would be a nice idea to make a simple shooting mechanic to allow the character to have both melee and ranged attacks. Many games change the camera view when using a gun for better target aiming. An easy way to do this is by creating a new virtual camera that follows the player using the third-person follow mode, where you can set variables like the shoulder offset and the camera side. Once you have both cameras set up, Cinemachine can automatically do a smooth transition between them using the values defined in the Cinemachine Brain component. So when aiming, all we do is change the priority property of the new virtual camera. Since we wanted our character to prepare for shooting, we needed a gun aim pose. But instead of having to create a separate keyframed animation, we decided to use the animation rigging package to create procedural motion. We did this by adding a two-bone IK constraint from the package into the character's right arm. The cool thing about the setup is that this allows the character to maintain the aim pose even when executing a jump animation, given that the constraint blends with the existing motion. Now for the projectiles, there are many different ways to spawn them in a Unity project, but a method that we wanted to experiment with was using the particle system, as it would be a simpler way to tweak and instantly see any modifications to speed, shape, and emission. In order for this to work, we needed to activate the collision field in the particle system and add a script to it that had the function onParticleCollision, which detects every time a particle hits another object. Once we had that working, we tied that up to the existing damageable system within the 3D game kit. Now that we had aiming and shooting, we thought it would be a good idea to build a modular system where we could add different kinds of abilities to our player. We did this by creating a mono behavior which every ability would derive from. It includes things like a cooldown timer and information about the ability. After that, it was easy to just create new abilities with any type of behavior by attaching them to our player. One of the abilities that we decided to create was a dash attack, which basically launches the player forward while also using the melee system to attack. And in order for this ability to feel super strong, we also made it so that the collision range of the staff weapon increased during the dash. Now it's important to mention that there are many ways to make your player move quickly towards a direction, but one great method for prototyping is by using the DOTween plugin, which allows you to easily create smooth animations with simple lines of code. When prototyping, it's also great to start testing visual effects in order to get a better sense of the feel of your game. With that said, we decided to start making the dash look more powerful by first creating a post-processing volume that activates during the ability. And we did so by modifying the weight value of the post-effect volume during the action. This volume has effects such as lens distortion, color adjustment, motion blur, and chromatic aberration. We also expanded the Toon shader graph by adding some nodes for a Fernando effect with some intensity controls to give the character this powerful aura. And to finish up the dash visual enhancement, we decided to add a particle system that uses a stretched billboard render mode to make the particles wider, giving that extra impression of speed. Then, to create the basic gameplay loop, we made a spawning system that instantiates enemies and makes them have more health points over time. And to finalize the prototype, we created some UI images for the ability backgrounds and icons. Since every ability has a cooldown time, we made it so that the icon had two backgrounds, and one of those would fill vertically as the ability recharged. By combining all of these features, we ended up with a very interesting mix of a third-person action prototype that had two types of attack and abilities that are powerful and have an appealing visual. The modular ability system was so interesting that we even decided to add another one that was a second type of a gun projectile, only much bigger and with a slower cooldown time. And that's all for today's video. You can download the project and watch a more detailed video about this prototype using the links in the description. Let us know what kind of prototypes are you making in the comments. Thanks for watching.